Thank you. That today we got justice inside that courthouse. And now we are wanting justice outside the courthouse. If we get only justice inside the courthouse, but not outside the courthouse, then we have no answer for Dante Wright's mom, and we don't have no answer for many other families who are yet to be named, because the system is still flawed. The system is still designed to kill black men. We don't need a court system to stop the brutality. We need policies to hold police accountable.
Yeah, right.
And until we get that, we are only be able to get justice inside the courthouse after we lose a loved one, and we are not ready for that. Today, Minnesota, God chose us for this moment. We did not know it. We didn't choose this moment, but God chose us for this moment. And those 12 juries carry the burden of bringing justice. Many of us were uneasy about today. Many of us were and had a lot of anxiety, and that is because we live in a system where a black person can be killed and not have the same justice system if you are a white person who's killed. But today, on this street, on this court, we have said enough is enough. And we have gotten a white officer who killed a black man to be guilty as charged. And so today we celebrate, but we do not put all our hope into this guilty verdict, because there are many families who did not get this type of justice. There are 470 families in Minnesota alone since 2000, and thousands of families across this country who have never got the justice that we saw displayed here today. Families who asked and pleaded for help never got the cameras that we had today, never got the sympathies that we got today. So today is an important day for all of us, but it's a day to hold a strong mirror in front of us, because if you think only Derek Chauvin is guilty, I would remind you, the Minneapolis Police Department is guilty. Yeah. The city of Minneapolis is guilty. Yeah. The state of Minnesota is guilty. Yeah. And this country is guilty. Yeah. And that we say since the killing of George Floyd on 38th in Chicago. The world moved. The world saw the brutality. Yeah. And they saw it at the comfort of their home, in a time we could not move because of pandemic. I believe that we needed that moment. We needed that moment. We needed less distractions to see the brutality that we have allowed our tax dollars to create, our tax dollars to kill and punish. But today, on this day, we are moving forward. And I want to say this personally today. The thought that came into my mind when I held guilty, guilty, and guilty was George Floyd on his last day, on his last hours, standing inside Cub Foods, dancing, dancing. And today, many people who are not born yet are dancing because we got a glimpse of justice, a glimpse of justice. But we have not got full justice until all of these families get justice. We don't have justice until we get the type of economic justice in this country. We don't have justice until we get educational justice for people of color in this country. But today, we are moving forward, and Minnesotans, God chose us. Let's carry on this burden. Let's shine a little bit of a light, a North Star light for the rest of this country, that we shine a light of justice for this country. And we let this guilty verdict flow on the Mississippi River all the way down to Delta to allow this country to taste what it's like for a little bit of victory, a little bit of victory. And with that I say, we thank God Almighty.
Yes.
We thank God Almighty.
Yes.
We thank God Almighty. But guess what? We are not done.
Right.
If you think we're going home, we're not going home. Three more officers have killed George Floyd. They, we need justice from them. And Dante Wright was killed in the middle of this trial to show us that the justice system in this country and accountability has yet to be had. And we will demand justice by any means necessary!
One down, three to go!
One down, three to go! One down, three to go! One down, three to go! One down, three to go! One down, three to go!
One down, four more to go! Four down, four more to go! And next, I'd like to go ahead and introduce the founder and the president of Family Supporting Families Against Police Brutality, Jashira Garaway.
Just for our community, but for the world. We must not forget
how we got here. Boots on the ground, blood, sweat, and tears, many tears. Seeking justice, which has been elusive for communities of color for some time. Let's not forget that this has been a road we have been marching on, fighting on, and dying on for generations. Unfortunately, it is a road we still must travel. We are in the state that has failed to pass reform that would have made an officer lose their job if they were affiliated with a white supremacist organization. We are the state that has communities of color looking like a third world country with the militarization and armament. We are the state that fails to correct the wrongs of the past and the deep wounds it has inflicted on communities of color time and time again. I question if we would have had this verdict had the people not hit the ground demanding justice, if there wasn't this outpouring of grief from the world, if the brave young girl had not recorded that viral video of George Floyd. I ask myself, is this what it takes to get justice for a person of color? Is this really justice? Sure, we have a guilty verdict. Sure, we have a settlement. But will things actually change? Absent any substantive change in policy, has anything really changed? How long before we're back here fighting for justice for another victim of police violence? We are in a state of affairs in our quest to obtain justice and equality, with Minnesota being ground zero of the mess that has sparked this outpouring of consciousness for our shared community. We are still here waiting to cash that check that has fallen on a bankrupt system of expedient politicians and administrators, intolerant allies of the same in opposition to progress for a more perfect union. This is where the fight is today, in this moment. The same elected officials who showed up to George Floyd's funeral are some of the biggest roadblocks to progress with legislation today. While other states have taken the leap in believing their communities and progressing, Minnesota is still beholden to the past. While we have concluded this nightmare in our quest for justice for George Floyd, a new nightmare has begun. A new quest has begun. As George Floyd's daughter put it, her daddy changed the world by showing the reality communities of color face time and time again. George Floyd changed the world by awakening the conscience and the people challenging their very sense of value and moral compass. George Floyd changed the world by showing a black man is a human being. Hey, we already knew this, but now you do too. During the funeral of George Floyd, I had the privilege to spend the day with Martin Luther King III, the son of the late Dr. King Jr. and his family. Martin Luther King Jr., a civil rights icon who freely gave his life to teach the world that dreaming was possible. And in that moment, and in our conversation, it was made clear that we cannot stop, we must keep pressing ahead, there's no going back, and the future is forward. We must continue to carry this fight to the legislators around the country. We must change, we must dismantle the systems that allow and have allowed the Derek Chauvins to thrive. We must evolve as a people and as a society. Our greatest failure will be to do nothing knowing what we know.